Now seeing that I have been given more tasks to accomplish here, I am reviewing the archives on the Enigma of Sophia. So far when comparing the information on Sophia, I am led to the conclusion that she is, for one, of human origin and not of the divine aspect, as she possesses free will to do and design as she chooses, which leads to her capacity to be capable of creating her son, the Demiurge. Something that never should have been, and states that it is not a part of God's design. However, it may have seemed that way then when this was written, but it has become obvious that the Demiurge eventually did play a part of his grand design and was actually a creation intended by God, as one of the last defending angels of creation. The Jewish legend of Shiva the Destroyer, also called Apollyon, or Abaddon. His role comes at the time of the end of days to cease a corruption of the heavens and is the last-minute effort to stop the final conflict from becoming the apocalypse, which is the destruction of the universe. So seeing this in the light of further events that have unfolded, the Demiurge, and his ability to shroud himself from God's sight and knowledge through manipulating the Ogdoads, or principalities which alert heaven to events that could tip the balance within creation towards destruction. This ability also clouds him from being detected by the rising enemy from within the celestial realms. God had set another course of defenders to stop this threat, but if they should fail, he had a failsafe backup that initiated the creation of the last archangel of heaven. This also can be found in the Vedic texts as the time of Kali Yuga, when Mahakala is said to step onto the earth. This outlines the effect this angel will have when he falls to the earth to achieve his destiny, and also is outlined in the Holy Bible that lists the destiny and his effect on creation and in heaven as Apollyon, the angel who was given the keys of the bottomless pit. So in summary, though it may have seemed like, even to Sophia, that her creation of her son, Sabad, was of her own design outside of the will of the true creator, we see that the Lord works in mysterious ways as see here, and that nothing is truly outside of his will, for if it was, then it just would not be. Though still I see this as a reverse attempt to undermine God's will by trying to corrupt these texts from the base of its roots, unlike what was done in the Bible by trying to corrupt it from its ending, causing a contradictive impression to casually change the texts through the inevitable restorations needed to be done to ensure its preservation across the spans of time, which becomes one of the fundamental factors behind what leads to the final conflict occurring. This, however, causes the final conflict to occur when it is first drafted, defying all the known aspects when they had first dictated them, and leads to it being denounced as false teachings at first, then gradually is accepted as possibly prophetic as time gradually goes on. An opposition to the Bible itself by its mirrored contrast of its effect on the faithful, and opposing it by its end destination that leads people away from salvation and towards desolation and destruction, where the Bible's intended effect is to lead those lost in destruction and desolation towards salvation. This is my compiled opinion of these works, so I would not take them as canonized words, merely a perspective of comparison. Also, there seems to be a possible hidden message or description of events I've noticed within the Gospel of Sophia. The same translation techniques I used when deciphering in Ox Tale can be applied here, which tells me that it may be possible that the Gospel of Sophia may have been first written around the same time of the chapters of Enoch, possibly by a student directly taught by the same author of the Dead Sea Scrolls, or taught in his style of scriptural writing. Such as the name Yaldasabad can be phonetically broken down and would describe not an angel per se, Baoth is an ancient Hebrew word that means angel or messenger, but it can also describe a healer. If I remember correctly, Yadaza means handsome, kind or entertainer, but most significantly its numeric value is 6, and if you move the third letter to the sixth letter's position, you have the Hebrew lettering, which combined using the 6-3 score and 6 notation, describing the mark of the beast, you'll have another word, Yadazal Baoth, which would translate to a handsome angel. On with the ancient meaning to angel would be a handsome healer of doctor of a sorts. This hidden message could be describing the unknown father of the Demiurge, a doctor, Since the description of the Demiurge describes the destiny of Satan, then Yuldarsabath, who was present in their 8th heavenly realm before creation, and that Sabath had assumed he was the creator being because none were present as far as he knew, but Sophia revealed he had come from the shadow within the darkness where Yuldarsabath had come from. This causes Sabath to go to war against the 7 realms of heaven and is the cause of Sabath being cast down. So associating the references of Sabath being Satan, Yuldarsabath being Lucifer, created before all lovers and an angel, then we come to the summarization that there are 9 realms of the heavens. Since Lucifer was a creation and angel of God, then by these accounts transcription, he would reside in the heavens above Lucifer and the other archangels who are manifested eons of his will, taking on a physical presence within existence. Also there, description of he who never should have been may be an entitlement given to children born out of wedlock or born not with her partner in this instance. Referring that the real father's identity was a doctor or maybe the mailman, haha, and that the reference to not being of Peli Roma could mean a child not of the father's actual lineage and conceived with another man. Also that, considering current events personally, I see this as a manipulation of events that have occurred with a warped version of the truth, secretly hidden to cause those who discover it to be led towards a false sense of truth. This would place the ones responsible for orchestrating this lie to be of someone who understands all this and would be someone in the current era or someone further ahead that would have known there. Truth enough to orchestrate such lies again at the efforts made to cleanse the heavens of the corruption that stain. Known angelic recorded names: Michael, Gabriel, Earl, Raphael, Israfel, Ariel, Ramael, Camille, Zadkiel, Cherub, Raziel, Seraph, Japhiel, Azrael, Regal, Haniel, Anamel, Anapiel, YWVH, Hesh, one of 2 angels who to Sodom and Gomorrah. Metatron, Saint Peter, heaven's official record keeper. Zerachiel, Apollo, God commands. Cassiel, Kafziel, speedy one of God. Saral, Seraphiel, Amiel, Marat, one of the 2 angels who went to Sodom and Gomorrah. Azazel, Beelzebub, God strengthens. Jeramiel, Muriel, Daniel, Sandalphon, Netzach, Barachiel, Chamuel, Cherubus, the original angel of death, also known as the ferryman in Greek legend, Phanuel, Turiel, Malkiel, Ornaphiel, Sataniel, Azraphiel, Thanes, Lucifer, Lucifiel, Lucifich, depending on what aspect of creation had taken control of him, Lightbearer, Son of the Morning Star. These names are a rough compilation and include both angels still in their heavenly positions and the fallen angels' names before their fall. Now before I continue, let's ask the question of what would happen if we removed those angels who we know to have fallen. What position would this leave heaven in, but most importantly, what weaknesses would it expose, in theory, for I know that there are deterrents for situations like this, but humor me so that we may be able to anticipate this antagonist's next move and cease his irritations that upset and pit brothers in arms against their allies, turning them into enemies. Okay, taking in the old rebel angels among the list and the recently targeted fallen angels, I would say this antagonist seeks to disarm and weaken God's strength, his defense, and diminish his power, as well as control the flow of information on the scenario by binding the holy scribes. Someone could be seeking a way to manipulate the heavens while leaving God himself open and vulnerable in the wake of the chaos that follows. Yes, exactly, and so we can anticipate the one who orchestrated this chaos to present the one he is working for at that moment, following the tail end of this. Given the methods used and tactics, it can be assumed that the one responsible has been hired or put up to this and is a prior enemy of heaven, as they seem to know exactly where to aim, so this is not their first time. Given the nature of attacks against each of the fallen angels and the struggles they each claimed to have undergone prior or during each scenario, that led to their action that caused their transgression. This enemy does not work with others and is a singular force that manipulates through others by setting the pieces into place and orchestrating his desired outcome. The next subject I wish to bring up is the appointment of the one who is set in place in my stead to oversee the affairs of hell while I am unavailable that I wish to bring to light. I have already discussed this with him and is aware of this discussion in case there are any retaliations from those seeking to undermine the rule of hell's hierarchy. Honestly, we are talking about the place where the universe's biggest assholes are sent and kept into one region, so complications can be expected. Heaven and even humanity, I sense, have some level of gratitude they hold for me becoming the way that I have, compared to the other anticipated outcomes that could have occurred. Many have wondered, as it seemed that there was a dark power that seemed to guide and watch over me at times. First, let me say that he wishes it to be known that though his power and influence has watched over me, he did not directly interfere with my will and that my actions from his standpoint were always my own, which is true. He merely guided me towards the perspectives that led me towards the truths and opinions I derived from what I was being led towards. For one, when this all began many years ago, none of what has transpired was even known to possibly occur. The reason he had approached me was because there was a plot from unholy powers that sought to stop me from becoming who I was meant to become. He knew it was my destiny to become Lucifer, but it was the council of the other eight princes of hell who sought to intervene and lead me towards becoming Apollyon the Destroyer instead. They planned on using the humans' social system that is corrupted and force me into the life of constant incarceration. After an entire lifetime of being institutionalized, they planned to mold their destroyer in the wake of that. It is because of him that I avoided that and has kept me safe from their schemes, but he has had to remain silent and in the shadows to keep the other council members from discovering his assistance to me. There was no deal for my soul involved. Just an agreement that when the time came to give him credit where credit is due. So as I stand here amidst my achievements of what has transpired and as the corrupted fall from their lofty heights in the wake of their schemes being brought to light, I thought that now would be the time to fulfill my end of that obligation and give credit to him for his help amidst the heavenly hosts and amidst mankind as well. This is why I have decided to appoint him as the steward of hell and its ambassador in my stead, when I am unavailable. Since this is a position that was appointed by God and his design that is his will, then I feel it would only be right to mention this so that his consideration to be appointed to this position may be official and not just conceived by my will. Though there have been many who have helped keep me on the right path by providing the wisdom and knowledge that has led me to become who I am, that ominous but reclusive dark presence that many sensed but could not clearly define watching over me was Belphegor. So now that this has been brought to light and we have a clearer image of what powers may be driving this force that assaults the heaven and who he is working for and who to expect in the wake of this chaos, I think I am about ready to hear the confession else off of there, other princes of hell. How about the hosts of heaven? And with a sharp two-edged sword that protrudes from his mouth, he is quick to cut down the lies of the sons of iniquity. And just in the nick of time, it seems too, as this sheds light on what is transpiring here and what exactly we are dealing with. Belphegor, I believe, may be the source of the antagonist, but it is not a position that he chose willingly. They must have caught on to his assisting me and would explain all these false impersonators of me and where they are coming.
People talk.